Welcome. This is the brand new XM122 IoT module from Acconeer, based on the Acconeer A1 pulse coherent radar. It features a Nordic NRF52840 Bluetooth system on chip that is based on a 32-bit ARM Cortex-M4. The XM122 supports single supply operating voltage from 1.9 volts up to 5.5. Furthermore, this module can run on a 3-volt coin cell battery. The XM122 is made specifically for IoT applications such as high precision distance measurements, presence detection, and speed detection. It's optimized for low power consumption and it features a built-in 2.4 GHz Bluetooth antenna with support for Bluetooth version 5, Mesh, Thread, Zigbee, etc. by the Nordic stack. Here we have the XM122. On the top side, we have the Acconeer A11 sensor. And on the bottom side, we have the Nordic MCU and an integrated Bluetooth antenna here. The board also has a B2B connector so that it can easily be attached to the XB122 breakout board. Here we have the XB122, the breakout board. Here we have the USB, which provides logging and flashing over UART. It also supplies power to the XM122 if you run it in USB mode. Here, we have the possibility to use a coin cell battery, this one, so that you can develop battery-driven applications. Use this switch, depending on if you want to run on the battery or the USB as a power supply. Please keep in mind that even if you choose battery, you need to have the USB connected to be able to get the UART logs. This is the serial wire debug. If you're developing programs later on, we suggest that you buy a J-Link programmer and use this header to flash. Here we have a MISC header for general purpose GPIOs, which are described here. Here in the middle, we have a trace header. And here on the side, we have two buttons for DFU mode. The DFU mode is used when you flash the programs over UART or Bluetooth. We have already done a bootloader for you that will enable you to flash all your programs. However, if you're thinking about deploying programs later on, you should replace this bootloader with your own. Today's mission is to get exploration tool to work to see live radar data through the laptop's UI. Let's download exploration tool and Python, which is needed to use exploration tool. So head over to the GitHub to download Acconeer Python exploration. Also, head over to python.org/downloads and download Python. Okay, Python is downloaded. Let's install Python. And don't forget to add Python 3.7 to path. Python exploration is a zip file, so let's extract it. Start the command line. Change directory to the extracted folder. Now we need to add some additionals to Python exploration. Let's check the homepage. Then we run the commands. And the last command. Let's see if we can run exploration tool. That works. Now it's time to flash the XM122. Start by going to the developer.acconeer.com, register, and then log in. After that, download the Acconeer XM122 module software. Now it's downloaded, and since it's a zip file, we need to extract it. After that, go into the extracted folder, into the bin directory, and then you'll see another zip file. That zip file needs to be sent to your phone, either via mass storage, MTP, or via email. I'll choose email. Okay, I'll bring up my phone, open the email, and download the file to the phone. And then I also need to download a software that will actually flash the XM122. So I'll go to Google Play, and I'll download NRF Toolbox for BLE. Let's connect the XM122 with the XB122. I'll connect the board-to-board connectors. And then I'll supply it with power. In my case, from the computer. Now I need to put the XM122 in DFU mode. So I'll press the DFU button, holding it, pushing reset, releasing reset, and then releasing DFU. Now I'll try to find it from my phone. I'll open the application. I'll click the DFU icon, select the file that I've downloaded. I'll choose application only. And then I need to connect the XM122 with the XB122 to actually be able to transfer the file via Bluetooth. And then upload the file. This might take a minute or two. Once this is done, start the exploration tool from your computer again. Select serial as interface, and then connect. And after that, you can choose your envelope service and start it. And that's all for today. Don't hesitate to contact me if you get into trouble.